Welcome, everybody, to Star Wars Wayward Spirit. We are ready to begin another session tonight, and let's get started, everybody, by rolling for Destiny.
Yes! Yes! Oh!
Is that everybody?
Yep.
All right, we got four light and three dark to get ourselves started.
No, six no. light.
Six light and two dark. It's like it didn't update.
All right, is everybody updated now?
No, I hit sync and it doesn't sync.
I've got four light and three dark on mine.
Yeah, but if you look at the actual rolls...
Kara's did not say rolling destiny point.
Oh, Kara just rolled a force die.
I'm sorry, that's me. Can you manually change it?
Yes, I can. So
okay.
Are we six light and three dark? That's a lot of force points.
Six light and two dark. I think it had Kara's old one in the dark, so yeah, it's...
Okay.
Only 8 points total.
I'll take that.
That's all a right, lot of destiny points.
So how does that look to everybody now? We got it?
Yes.
Also, okay. I think you misspelled Seleucami on your lower third, which I like, by the way.
Oh, thanks. I'll try to get that corrected when I can. So here we are. You followed up on a lead that you received through your friend Corvin Dare and discovered a mysterious crate that was being transported into the Outer Rim on the famous ship, the Prolemian Hall, which is an Imperial transport vessel. You've opened the crate. You have discovered that it contains a Sith holocron, and not just any Sith holocron, but one that is apparently of tremendous power. You found a contact, an older mysterious pirate, who suggested that you try to seek out help before attempting to open the holocron, and thus far you've done that. To open it, of course, what you want to do is communicate with its personality and find out more about why the Empire had possession of it and what the Empire wanted from it. So now you are on the planet Seleucami, and on this planet there is a criminal syndicate that is rumored to have imprisoned a member of the fabled Church of the Force. And now you're hot on the trail of this prisoner. You've learned about a mining facility that is operated on the planet by a corporation named Salcorp, but you've concluded that this Salcorp is actually a front for a local organization that's known as the Spice Syndicate. And you think that if you go to this mining facility, you're going to be able to locate this prisoner, at least according to the somewhat unscrupulous contact, Arkea Sidala, that you interacted with during the last game.
So nearly
now you've
shot.
Come together somewhere. It can either be your choice out on the streets or at your ship, and it's time to talk about what you want to do next.
And we have the mines. If my mic is working on this.
Yes,
it is.
Okay. There we go.
Yeah, it's you're not good. Too loud.
Nope. Well,
but
we...
do you think we can get in there, or is it going to be a gunfight?
It's a gunfight that we can vouch for, at least.
I did hear a lot of gunshots, you know, blasters going off when I tried to meditate on what would happen next, so it's pretty possible that there's going to be fighting, but when is there not fighting when we're doing something?
Let's see. Is it possible to do some sort of underworld check to determine who these spice dealers would be working with in case I wanted to impersonate a group and say that we're representing this said group, like I don't know, the Black Sun or something?
Sure.
Them, anything like that.
Sure, if somebody wants
or
to
if anyone has a better suggestion,
that's fine.
Works for me.
Let's not mess around small town. We're from Black Sun.
Now, I'm Prince Sheezel.
To be fair, I think if we claimed we're from Black Sun, that seems like big time enough that they'd listen no matter what, unless they're specifically not working with Black Sun and an enemy of them.
Well, you only live once. Does anyone have a higher intelligence than mine, which is 2, because my underworld is only 2 green?
I've got it.
Yeah, Lorelei and Kara, I think, both have 4.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so I got the street smarts. Someone else has the underworld smarts.
What's your rank? What's your rank of knowledge underworld, Koskett?
Nothing.
Don't you have a rank?
I have no rank.
Yes, I have the yellow in underworld.
So there you go.
So what difficulty will that be?
What's Lorelei got in underworld?
I got 4 green with a -2 setback advantage.
Okay. Yeah, I just have 1 rank in underworld, so I could try if anyone wants to give me a boost.
So we can do a hard check, and we can take advantage of kind of Kira and Lorelei getting their heads together. We can take advantage of Lorelei's ability to not have any setback die on the check.
Okay.
And then one person can add a boost to that if they want to try to assist, and you can describe how you're assisting.
Basically, I was going to say, for mine, it's like we're putting our heads together. I'm filling in the blanks that she, like, vaguely puts out. So.
Oh, I heard of these one people from, what's that planet with the giant water slide part? Like,
that's what she'd pissed if I can use my contacts in some shape, form, or fashion. Why not? That seems to have done terrifically.
Yes.
So between the two of you, you're able to figure out this is a clan that has very close ties to the Huts and to more than one of the Huts. Like they obtain this stuff largely as a middleman and filter it through to the Huts, and then it goes into kind of their spice distribution system. They're not known as being particularly powerful on a galactic scale, but they're pretty influential on this particular planet. So you're going to probably encounter a lot more power here and force here than you would off-world with them. What else do you want to know? You got a lot of success here.
Which specific clan of Huts they work with the most?
They're rumored to be associated with 2 or 3 different clans.
What's a good vaguer one that would take a longer time to contact if we wanted to pretend to be them?
No.
I'm pulling out my list of Khajiits just to... I mean, you can just do Dasilajic if you want the most common one, or Basadi is the next.
Yeah, Basadi doesn't sound too bad, actually.
Yeah, the Basadi.
We'll call it Basadi just so that if we run into somebody, it won't be Jabba.
That's good. Yeah, the Basadi. The Basadi.
This time and period is Gardula in charge. Durga is not, or maybe Durga is already working for the Black Sun. He's a Vigo, right?
Not that I would know that.
So we can say that we're from this Hut clan? But do Huts normally work with other people?
Other people work for Huts in their mind, I think.
That's basically it, yeah.
Okay, and... Oh, be quiet, Koskett. We're both very smart, intelligent women, thank you very much. Alright, so we know the Hut clan we're going to say we're from. Maybe with the other success, we have a valid reason for the Huts to come snooping around?
Inspecting operations, cleanliness, making sure stuff. I mean, there's probably generic...
Heck, if we had a slicer and we could just somehow get some sort of logs or... shipping manifest or something like that. We could be we're here to pick it up. Or,
how's the slicing, Kara?
I'm pretty good at it.
But how close do we have to get to access that information?
A few yards.
Because if we could just walk in there and be like, yeah, we're here to pick up this delivery.
I mean, if I focus really, really, really hard, I can use the force to slice something.
With your lightsaber?
No, with... Look, I've been practicing some stuff.
She can type from across the room. It's kind of scary, and I really hope she's not doing it in combat, but I can't see her back there, so...
Back where? I have a lightsaber.
No, I mean when you're in engineering.
Oh, yeah. No, I totally do all the time.
Great.
Well, yep. Does anyone else have any suggestions before we go down this path?
You could try to slice into their systems. You could just try to do some research on, you know, just try to put your ear to the ground, so to speak, and see what you could pick up as well. I don't know. Those are a couple of options.
Yeah, I can try and slice into something and see if they've had any complaints against the mine itself that, like, would send someone to inspect it. Like, oh, there's been, you know, a shortage of supplies. So...
They're not getting shipped the right amount, stuff like that.
Well, we could always just bluff and say that.
Forge a
That's picture. True. Even if they were getting the right amount, we could still shake them up.
Yep. Yeah, we could do that.
Not a terrible idea.
But maybe finding out a name of somebody. Like the person that's, you know, running the foreman.
I already have a name. It's called Do You Know Who I Am?
No, we need to know who we're asking for. If we show up, we say we're from the Kajitic, we demand to speak with Foreman X. It gives us some
credibility,
yes.
Well, if we're going this route, I would love to use a talent I picked up ages ago and have never, ever used. Bad press.
What's that?
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Once per session, I can make a bad press action by choosing a specific organization. In this instance, it would be the spice dealers. And make a hard deception check. And if I succeed, members of that organization have their wounds threshold reduced by one, plus one per additional three successes, to a minimum of one until the end of the session. And I do have, I did buy that media kit that's on the ship.
Cool.
So I can put out a false story about them.
That's pretty sweet.
That's an awesome idea. Yeah. Starting some rumors that the Hutts aren't happy with them.
Yep.
Let's do that then.
I like that idea.
But I still think we should figure out a name, but we can probably figure
that
out.
We can ask around for a name.
Yeah.
Kara and Doc, I don't know if you want to... Can you scrap together like a chemistry set so we can test the purity of their stuff when we're in there? Do you think that would lend us some credibility, or...
I think so.
I mean, you can use a simple alkaline setup to do a... kind of a drug test.
Can make it look really fancy and like professional. Get some like some beakers and some test tubes and make like a whole big set. And we can put it in a big box and we can press a button and it opens up. Let's do that.
That is a better idea than going in there and saying they're shorting the spy shipments, just saying that it's not potent enough or it's not...
Yeah, just that we have questions.
And then we can rig it so that it says it's not potent enough.
Yeah.
Even if it is.
Yeah, all you have to do is create...
Or you could let me run the test and I just
shake it. It doesn't even read the sample. It just spits out a not potent result.
I think the doc had a good idea. We'll just let her do it, and what are they going to know what she's doing?
She's a doctor.
She's going to be able to feign it real well, so...
All right, so I'll make the kit... So that it's like a briefcase, and when you press the button, it like opens up really cool, like.
And see, and then when we say it's not potent enough, we can demand to see their operations, and then we have free reign to walk around and find the prisoner.
We're all so smart.
Then we find the prisoner we're looking for. We claim that he is a known enemy of the Hutts, and that he snuck his way in here, and we'll deal with him.
And we'll walk out with him, hopefully.
And walk out.
Okay, first, before we do anything, before we go into a spice mine, I'm just going to say, as the mother of this band of
I miss Linger giving us the speeches.
I know, Dad was better.
Yeah. He got to the
Dad
point.
Dad would just tell you he's disappointed in you.
No, I'm talking about Slinger, not actual Adlar.
Oh, yeah, sorry. But no doing spice while we're in the spice mines.
This shit isn't up to quality. Put that back on our starship.
Yeah. Oh, this is the good stuff. You get that to the ship right now.
I mean, this is bad. Oh, yeah.
Then I'm going to deal it out to Slinger soldiers.
No. No spice. We're not taking any spice back with us.
Oh, before we do go into the mines, you need to fix my blaster.
Oh, yeah, I can do that. How do I do that?
Anyway, Matt, have you read the bad press, and can I make that as a action?
I'm looking at it right now. It looks like it's a hard deception check. And I'm going to go ahead and spend a destiny point on that. So give yourself an upgrade on the difficulty.
All right.
Good enough.
So Koskett goes out and over the course of an hour or two manages to create a certain amount of terror about what could happen to the spice syndicate as a result of some questionable shipments.
Has a poorly drawn picture of Durga the Hutt on there with a frowny face.
Well, that's pretty good.
I'm just happy I finally used that talent. I've had it forever.
Pretty soon we'll have all the light side points. Matt, what would be the check for fixing Koskett's or IG's weapon?
What are you trying to do with the weapon?
Did it break IG?
It got bad motivated.
You drew bad motivator on it?
Yes.
That's why someone's still alive, that they shouldn't be alive.
Yeah, let's make that an average mechanics check.
All right.
And since you're working on the street, well, you already rolled it. Go ahead and roll a setback. I don't think it's going to make any difference. We'll add that to the check.
There we go.
Okay. So
just
we've got the weapon.
In the street.
Kira manages to tinker with the weapon a little bit, get it repaired, hand it back to IG.
And before we go, can I do a mechanics check to get the drug testing kit made up all fancy-like?
Yes. Let's do another combined check with let's see how to do it. Let's do one check for Dr. Lorelei on the medicine to kind of give you the guidance that you need, and then we'll do a mechanics check for you. So the medical check's just going to be an average check.
Well, okay then.
Wow.
So tell me how you want to spend that triumph.
Let's say it gives an advantage to the deception. Or it gives me advantage to the deception. Because it looks authentic.
Okay, so you're going to take a free advantage, an extra advantage, when you do your deception checks on this.
All right, so now I have to do the mechanics check.
Your mechanics is going to be a hard check.
All right, and I'm going to use a destiny point.
Okay.
I know, right? Really, that's all I get? No triumphs at all?
So you managed to create a very awesome-looking drug testing kit.
I want to take it.
But I don't like the fact that it's a drug testing kit. Take a strain. I'm still mad at Koskett about the drug thing.
It's the only problem is there's a few nicks on it. There's you've got that threat there, so we'll say there's a few nicks on it. Got a little damage while you were putting it together, but it still does the job.
The whole time she's putting it together, she's just thinking Koskett would fail this.
So what's next?
Let's head out there. Let's go do this. Do we want to get some...
Hold on, we need to find out who our contact is.
Oh, that's right.
Oh yeah, let's have Koskett ask around.
What's Koskett asking around about?
Who the foreman is, just to get us some... a little bit of credibility.
Just to give us a name of somebody we need to see. Whoever's in charge out there.
Okay.
Well, I know a guy.
So let's do a streetwise check. That's hard with a setback because you've got a Bothan walking around asking questions about criminal organizations.
That's not shady.
Not at all. Deception, it could be some scold. People don't want to talk to the Bothan.
There is one thing I want to take advantage of. What was it? Informant? No, not that one. Not dodge. Positive spin. I got too many talents. Something about, I think, in the know. Does that show emphasis? And make imposed.
Oh, isn't there that one talent where if you're... Or no, it's if you're getting interviewed, people don't realize that you're a propagandist or something like that.
Yeah, I have improved in the nose, so it's like I can make a deception versus vigilance check with difficult downgraded once per rank. So I can sort of go around, if I find someone with streetwise, to get this information, essentially make this check so they don't know that I'm actually representing the Rebel Alliance or the Huts. I can just not give my... Yeah. Anyways, I'll go ahead and make that streetwise first. I don't have any setback that I can remove from it, like I can with everything else.
No, I said there was a setback on it.
Oh, well, yeah, I can't remove it, though.
Oh, okay.
I can remove it from deception and skullduggery. It's all good.
Koskett manages to find someone who is loose-lipped enough to give away the fact that there is a supervisor / manager at this Salcorp plant. It's known as Littrell, Littrel.
Oh, I was trying to think of a bad joke. Don't listen to me.
I take it back, and then no, it does remove a setback, though.
So two successes.
Yeah, it's all good. The guy that gave me the information can start some rumors with my improved in the know so that I can spread the false information that these guys are upsetting the Huts on top of the propaganda I've already started, and just let that get around. And also it doesn't come back to me. I just want, you know, as much pressure on these guys as possible.
Okay.
That way they'll be extra nice to us.
Did we do your in the know check yet?
Yeah, it's opposed deception versus vigilance against whoever it is I'm talking to, who's going to I'm going to give this false information to, so he can spread it.
Okay.
So do we need to go find like an info chant or something?
Technically, I don't even have to find anyone, but the guy that I got the information from, I could just go ahead and use him.
Oh, okay. So you're just going to find a bartender and grouse or something, and then it gets around. That's awesome.
Yeah.
We'll do that against an average check with one upgrade. So you're talking a red and a purple.
Okay.
Jeez.
Wow.
Impressive.
So repeat for us again, Koskett, what it is that's circulating now about these people.
I'm trying to spread rumors on top of the propagandist, like the, I don't know, the media I put out, that the spy syndicate is shorting their end on the huts and not...
How about cutting the spice?
Yeah, cutting the spice and or the quality of the spice. And that the huts are very upset to put more pressure on these guys. So when we show up there, they've already heard all these rumors anyway, so it doesn't seem unlikely that the huts would check it out.
Could you add that they were actually sending some people to check into this?
Yeah. I'd like to let that get around town. But if you want to look at that, it's called In the Know, the improved version. Second to last on my talent list. Really nifty talent that I don't get to use a lot. So I'm trying to use the propaganda stuff I really haven't gotten to use much of.
Koskett, you're going to help us take over a city at some point.
can only hope.
You're going to help the rebellion take over a city.
This could be what we're starting here. Take down the spice dealers here. Take over.
Yes, take down the spice dealers. We don't want spice.
At this point,
secretly, me and IG reopen it behind everyone.
Koskett's going to end up like Booster Tarek, where he has an entire Star Destroyer to himself. That's the dream, right? Painted red.
Wow, can you imagine IG running the turbo laser battery?
You'd have to pull an IG-88 and clone yourself for every
yeah. turret. Yeah. Well, no, you can direct whole gunnery banks for mass combat. IG would be a perfect ship gunnery commander.
Use my a nice outfit.
Yeah, Kara doesn't think she fits. She's like, okay, we have the doctor. Okay, Lorelai looks the part. Yeah, Anden looks the part. Koskett looks the part. Kara's like, I'm covered in grease. Why am I coming along? She's afraid someone's gonna like ask about it and be like, "Who's this chick over here?"
Don't you have laminate armor or something?
She has like scrap pieces of stormtrooper armor.
Great. So somebody will hand her a spare rifle. You don't have to use it. Just stand there acting like you're one of the hired guns.
With my big stick.
Yeah. Everyone will assume it's a quarterstaff.
And my giant backpack.
Can she borrow that at home? Force her talent.
Do what?
She needs to temporarily borrow the enforcer specialization.
Whatever. Take one of the guns. We're leaving the squad of troopers on the ship, so take one of their rifles. You don't have to use it. Just carry it. Leave the toolkit at home.
I'm not leaving my toolkit. Well, I'm bringing my spanner.
Bring a spanner. Bring the fusion cutter. I don't care.
Oh, I can bring the fusion cutter.
But you also got the stick, so you won't need the fusion cutter.
I know, but I like that.
You should put that in the other end of the stick.
Oh!
Although that makes it really hard to use as an actual tool, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Alright, so, fine.
After doing this for a little while, how's the word around town about this going down? Is it big news now, since not only did I decimate or spread the information with that, I also did the media earlier, so that's almost like doubling it up.
The big news around town is that the huts are PO'd at the Spice Syndicate and that they're coming to lay down the law.
Yes.
Well then let's get going. Let's do this.
Now I need you to tell me how you want to go there. Do you want to take your ship? Do you want to rent a speeder? It's in a rural, somewhat remote location.
I say we fly straight in.
Yeah, let's fly in like we don't have anything to hide and just park a safe distance away if we can help it.
I feel like we've done something like this before.
Oh, God.
Okay, that worked out okay.
That did work out okay. That worked out really well.
Until somebody couldn't get the ion cannon firing properly.
That was one of those moments.
That's water under the bridge.
Had never happened to me before.
That is ionization in the exhaust stream. It's not...
I think that was one of those moments earlier where Matt needed some time to come up with something.
All right, they'll sneak through the tunnels at night and come to the base.
Let's just fly there like we know what we're doing.
Okay, well, that's maybe every 2 weeks we play this game.
And then we drank their wine. It was great.
I told him to shoot the white men. Alright. Hey, Kara can change while we're here. She's going to dress into something a little more appropriate for hired gun.
Just put the armor on, take the giant snap-on toolbox off your back, and you'll be fine.
She's going to carry her backpack, though.
She should totally just dress like a private dancer. That just comes along.
Hey, we do work for the Huts.
A few hours later, you manage to land the Wayward Spirit. How far away do you want to land the thing from the outside of the mine? Basically, what you see from the air is you see an office complex, and then it looks like there's some tracks that lead into and then down into a mountain behind it.
Do they look like they have any anti-air defenses or anything, or does it just look like a civilian operation?
You don't see anything that looks anything like an anti-air defense.
Well, I vote we just commandeer one of the landing pads like we, you know, like we're supposed to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we are.
Yep. And I'll bring it on in.
I'll set tripod to watch and make sure everything's cool.
Yep.
Hi, tripod.
By the way, I forgot. What do we call huts? Master? Lord?
Benefactor?
Exalted one?
Yeah.
Yes, pretty much.
Durga is the boss of this family, isn't he? So I could just say the exalted Durga the
esteemed. Lorelai, think of some really good, fancy titles for people.
You're well on your... I mean...
I think we're on top of it.
Okay.
I would say if Mr. Koskett here is going to do it, I would do it more in the formality he's accustomed to. You know, his lordship or something like that. The esteemed or exalted usually is more droid-esque.
You might be able to... Yeah, I agree. And you might just be able to... Just kind of give it the my employer with all the weight behind that kind of gives them a spectral presence.
By the end of this, Durga actually does hire us.
Hey, you might.
Goodness gracious.
So you manage to get the ship landed on the pad. You've opened up your landing ramp. You can see right in front of you there's a walkway that leads from the landing area into the main office, straight through a front door into the main office.
Are there any security forces around?
You can see here and there some people that are wearing security guards. There are various different races, and they don't tend to look real uniform or particularly neat either. This doesn't strike you as typical corporate security.
Good.
All right, so IG will walk down the ramp first, kind of post up at the bottom and look around for a second before everybody else comes out.
Lorelai, you got the cool case, right?
Right here.
Awesome, good.
There are a few really people cool milling around. They don't really pay much attention to you.
Excellent. I'm just going to follow Koskett.
Yeah, I'll stay with Anden.
And I'll follow up in the back with IG.
Stroll down that ramp like I own it.
You can buy and sell this place.
Koskett's short, but he stands tall. Like, Got that intimidating factor.
Until gunfire starts and I'm cowering behind the droid.
You're like, oh god, what do I do?
And we're going into the offices?
Yep. Throw those doors open as we enter.
This slide.
So his hands are sticking out like he was going to push them open.
Yeah. Let me try that again. That's not really the entrance I was going for. I'm going to go back on the ship. I'm going to do a circle. We're going to land.
Try this again.
Yeah, we're going to do this right.
One sec.
All right. Hello.
Can you see yourselves there?
We sure can.
Yep. You walk in the door, and we may use Koskett there for now to kind of represent the party overall. You all look kind of cramped in that room.
Sure.
But Koskett walks in. There's one guy sitting behind a desk. Again, looks a lot more thuggish. He's a Twi'lek, but looks very thuggish. Not very corporate at all. And his eyes just slowly trail up from the desk to Koskett as he walks in. And he doesn't seem to quite know what to make of watching Bothan stride into the room like that.
I look at him almost demeaningly, and I'm like, you know why I'm here. His Lordship Durga the Hutt has sent me to investigate these procedures.
He says, I mean, it's clear he's heard these rumors, and he's a little bit intimidated by what you're saying. And he says, well, hang on a minute, and I'll get you the manager that's in charge right now. Just wait here, he says. And he walks out this door. What's going on? Here we go. He walks out this door. How's that?
All right. I'm going to make sure I've got the blaster ready in case something stupid happens.
Something stupid always happens.
Well, of course. We're usually the ones that instigate it.
Yeah, I'm gonna commit my force die, if that's okay.
It's your force die.
Just get ready to go.
A couple of moments later, a character walks into the room. This is yet another Twi'lek, and let me see if I can get him revealed for you so that you can see him in your character list.
There he is.
And I apologize, this is not another Twi'lek. This is actually a rather nasty-looking human. And he's going to be a little bit more difficult, you can tell right away, person to convince about anything. One of the first things that you notice about him is he's carrying some kind of heavy blaster, and it looks like a bad heavy blaster that could do some serious damage, and he's got it on his back, not threatening you with it, but he's definitely given you the once over, trying to assess exactly who you are.
IG, enforce me.
Well, I don't have Loom yet, but I do have a Fearsome, so I can force him to make a fear check. Worth a shot.
You have your brood squad, I have my brood squad.
Who's got the bigger blaster?
You are the brood squad.
So So that would, right now it's just an easy check, so he'd probably pass it, but it may give him pause.
Okay. We're using what talent here?
Fearsome.
Okay.
Showdown.
Turns out IG is just really not that fearsome.
Probably not.
Not yet.
Upgrade it.
His reputation does not precede him yet.
So he's going to make an easy fear check.
Right.
But even if he passes with disadvantages, that can still inflict strain and things, so...
Here we go.
Aww.
Not scared of IG.
All right, can I shoot him and try it again?
Not shoot anyone yet. let's you know.
Anyways, no advantage there. Thanks, IG.
Hey, I just shoot at stuff right now. Sorry.
He says, "What exactly can we do for you people?"
My master sent me here to investigate these rumors that I'm sure you've heard by now. It's circulating all around the city.
I look very upset. Frowny face.
He says, "And what rumors exactly are those?"
Can I flip a destiny point to have one of those little media things I printed off earlier and slam it down on the table that's all around town that
yes,
I printed off
can.
My media manipulator?
Nice. Boom.
Next time we make some money cheating at cards, we got to get Casca a data pad.
Casca doesn't have a data pad?
I did.
I got a sword cane.
Actually, you did, because that's what we used to communicate with the Zell.
That might have been Kara's.
That could have been.
Yeah.
Anyway.
The Heavy picks up the flyer, looks at it, and he says, "So what? Lots of people think the Huts are angry with him. The Huts are always angry at somebody." Tosses it aside.
"And right now, my master is angry with you."
Let's go ahead and do a deception check. And we're going to have three boosts. Or is there a specific effect to your talent? If not, we'll give you three boosts on the check.
No, I don't have a specific effect for anything like that.
Okay. And well, on this one, we're going to do two red die.
Oh, gosh.
But you get your three boosts.
And I get one automatic advantage.
Ooh. Is that from the clothes?
That's from my jewelry.
Ooh.
I do get something from my clothes, just not the... I'm not... acting as a noble or anything, so I don't really get any bonus there. Yoink.
Holy Toledo.
Wow. Jesus.
Seven advantage.
Wow, all three of those boosts came through for me.
They
thanks,
sure did.
Media yes. Manipulation.
You are a good propagandist. You give the Botham you make the Botham propagandist in my other game look like garbage. Luckily, that's an NPC, so he doesn't have to be perfect.
There's another Casket.
His name's Call, and his idea is, let the Imperials massacre people, because I'll be able to make a sweet documentary about it. Guarantee it'll get you recruits. And you couldn't save all these people anyway, so...
Oh, boy.
He says, well, you can go back home and tell your master that... you've spoken with the manager of the facility out here and that he has personally assured you that there are no problems with these shipments.
Hmm.
Don't we have a test?
I'm gonna nudge Koskett and just be like, I don't, you know, I'm just a hired gun, but I don't think your handsome, charming pilot flew you all the way out here to take someone's word for it.
I'm looking for, I think, the cutting question. I want to use my deception as a coercion skill check and be like, and sort of be like, so, what are you hiding back there if you're not going to let us look at it? You heard me very loud and clear when I said my master wants us to examine this. And I'm kind of using my coercion to strong arm him. And to, I'm pointing out he's clearly hiding something if he's not going to let us back there. If he had nothing to hide, it wouldn't be a problem.
Now, you had success on the deception check, so you don't have to make another check. He says, well, okay, if you want to come in and take a sample for a minute and have a look at what's coming with our next shipment, you can do that. But then I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
I'm just going to look at him glaringly and be like, fine, a sample is what we came here for.
And he says, follow me, and he heads through this door.
Hopefully we're all allowed to follow, right?
We better be.
I'm following regardless.
I want to get the middle finger when he turns around.
Hey, he might be on sneak.
He takes you into this room over here. And there's a few tables in the room. There's some junk sitting on some of the tables, but he pulls out a smaller tube and opens it up and offers what's inside, which looks like some kind of fairly potent spice.
Is there only one door for this place?
There's only one door in this particular room.
This is the only door in this room.
All right. I'm going to post up right there by the door.
Okay.
That way he can't come out, and anybody coming in, I can get the drop on him.
Okay.
Is there any cameras in this room? That's my next question.
Easy perception check.
Can, like, all of us do that to...
I don't think we need to.
Okay.
Yeah. No.
Yes, there are definitely cameras. There's at least two, and they both appear to be functioning.
I'm going to elbow Kara.
Yeah, there we go. The eye contact. Like, look at Kara, look at the camera, look at Kara, look at the camera.
Okay. Is there a place where I could try and kind of move into, like, a blind spot with the camera?
I'm going to shake my head at her. I'm just going to hold out my hand like I'm moving something with it. And then act like I'm unplugging something.
Yes, that's the plan.
Well, you don't need to be hiding from the camera to go like this.
Well, I mean, I don't think Kara can just simple little hand gestures.
Sure.
Okay, fine.
In the meantime, I can try to get his back turned toward all this and bring... Lorelai over, and as we're setting up our box and all that.
If he's putting it out there, I'll kind of lean into Koskett and going, you're going to need to push more on the fact that this could be a staged sample. But I'll use it as a base to compare it to so we have an edge.
Yeah, how quickly did it take him to produce this sample? Did he have it on hand already?
We're in a break room.
He's got a brick of spice in the break room.
Yeah, see, that's suspicious. We should demand to go to the processing.
Well, that's why I was suggesting that if he shows us this will give us a comparison to the actual shipment.
If he produced it very quickly, I almost want to try to get a boost on any sort of check I would make toward that, saying that clearly he has seen all the rumors because he already had a false sample on hand.
He says, I assure you this isn't a false sample. And as far as the processing goes, you know that's done in another facility. That's not done here. This is just the front that we use for our operations. He says, I thought you were here to pick up the prisoner.
We'll deal with that in a minute. Business first.
Did we spread a lie about the prisoner?
No.
Just roll with it.
He was originally here for the prisoner, but along the way, these rumors came out. So we've got to take care of business before we take care of business.
He says, fine, go ahead. There's nothing wrong with it.
I just look at Lorelei.
Mm-hmm. And she'll take it. You know, did the whole, like, pull the thing out, put the, you know, just, you know, razzle-dazzle the different chemicals, put, you know, break apart the sampling, put it in a different one, shake it, you know, it turns blue, you know.
Make sure you're wearing safety gloves and proper PPE.
Yes, she's a doctor. She's going to be, like, okay, safety first, you know.
She's throwing, like, Alka-Seltzer in there to make it foam up so it looks impressive, but it's not actually testing anything.
Meanwhile, Koskin just snorts some of it.
Yeah, it's okay. Do you have another sample? There's only one way to test.
Something happened to your sample. It's all gone.
Matt, can Kara do her move, manipulate, all the way down to manipulate to unplug the cameras?
It's a talent that she's got, manipulate?
Yeah, manipulate with force move, with... force move, so she can, like, literally...
I understand what you're trying to do now. I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
What's your range?
I have 2 range, so...
Medium.
If you spend a pip, you can go up to long, basically.
But I would believe these would be at least medium range.
Yeah, so you'll have to spend
a pip. They're both within medium range. That's not a problem, but we are talking about 2 different checks.
Unless you have magnitude, which you probably don't have.
No, I have hurl, pull, manipulate, and strength.
Shame.
I know.
You can use... it's going to be 2 different efforts. You can try one of them now if you want.
Sure. To unplug one of them.
Right. And then we'll come back and try the other one later.
Yup.
Like I said, I'll do the whole thing. And what I plan... In the old situation is, like, I'll get both of them to turn kind of blue-ish, and I'm sure they're going to probably come out a little different, and take a piece of it, put it in a container just as it is, and say, we'll have to use this as our base sample to compare upon the shipment. But thus far, I will consider this one a positive and this one a false positive.
I want to take my finger on one of them and just sort of take a small sample myself.
And personally. Bat your hand.
Since I am an expert in these things.
He says, what do you mean by false positive?
Take a look at the 2 samples. It is the same consistency, but there's a possible contaminant in there. I'll have to run under an analysis to confirm it. But for the time being, they are in the same consistency, so therefore they are positive. It's just I will need to verify it. That's why I will need this as a base for the second, for the return.
He said, well, as I said, you're not going to find anything more in any other quantities here besides what you're looking at right now. This isn't the place where we do the processing, and most of it's not even stored here.
I look to Koskit. For the time being, this will give them some assurances, but that way they'll have something to compare it to when they deliver it.
Want to, like, sample it and be like, I don't think it'd be much of an issue. And try to get this business concluded so we can press on to the next bit of business. Prisoner.
Matt, you did see that I was going to spend those pips, right?
Oh, you are going to use the pips.
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, I typed it up. I'm sorry.
You just need one. You could just take one conflict and one stress.
Alrighty.
And you've got one of the cameras unplugged.
Nice. Can I use bad motivator on the other one?
You can use bad motivator on the other one.
Actually, no, I'll wait. One's good for now. Maybe in a bit. So are we going to go get the prisoner now? Is that our thing here, or is this guy? I'm sorry. Yeah, boss. Cosket, or the other boss.
Somebody make a perception check.
You're muted, by the way.
Sure, I got that. How hard?
We're going to do one purple, one red.
Oh, well, I'm not that good at it. Let's see what we get. Okay, that's by itself. Let's try this again.
Andon's too busy looking in the mirror to notice. Oh, there we go. Yeah, Lorelai's closer in to this heavy, and she can just vaguely perceive that he's got an earpiece on, and there's someone talking to him as he's speaking with you in the earpiece. That's all you know, is he seems to be in communication with somebody while he's interacting with you.
I lean into Cosket. We're being watched and monitored.
Bad motivator?
On the earpiece that I probably don't know exists?
That would be a pretty nifty situation, though. I don't have anything for this situation at all.
Use force move manipulate to knock it out of his ear.
I thought it was a bug.
Oh, no. I just want to use manipulate because it's super cool.
Huh, it didn't register the red. Okay. Well, I'll take it either way.
Well, I mean, if someone points it out to Kara, she can try and do something, but I don't know if bad motivator's the right thing for this. You know? Obviously, you just have to...
I've used all my talents for useful situations. The only other thing I have is to look at IG and just say, shoot him.
Let's just wait and see. We don't know who he's talking to.
Yeah,
that's true. I'm thinking they're searching our ship. I don't know.
Hopefully Tripod will let us know. I locked it.
Yeah. Tripod will let us know if anything happens.
He says to you, now if that will be all, we've got some things we need to take care of here.
Yeah, let's get our prisoner. It's who we came to escort.
Oh, so you are here to get the prisoner?
We're here for both. Cosket said that.
Yeah, you have to take care of business before we can take care of business.
He says, very well, just one moment, and he starts to walk out the room.
Can...
Follow.
Oh, I'm not engaged with him. Crap.
Only we had
IG's blocking the door, isn't he?
No, I'm off to the side of the door.
I understood he was about right here. And honestly, at this point, it probably wouldn't hurt for everybody to put their tokens down where they're at.
I'm standing next to Cosket.
Should we shrink our tokens down?
I can't.
I don't know that we have to shrink the tokens, but let's go ahead and get everybody placed.
There we go. Oh boy, this is weird. There's no exit. Is there any exits?
There's the one he's in. About to walk out.
There's nothing down here?
That's personal.
No. There's a wall down there.
And blow up the wall.
And
with what? Gone.
I don't know. Something?
I don't know. All right. The one that always brings your toolkit everywhere. Fashion a shaped charge.
All right, I'm going safety off and aiming at the door.
How about I just lock the door? They can't come in.
We can't get out.
There's got to be a way to get out of here.
Yeah, the same way we came in, we just shoot on the way.
Can Kara, now that no one's in here, can she just go up and unplug the other one? The other security camera?
By the way, I think we may have missed on a roll. We needed to do Lorelei's deception roll a minute ago.
Okay.
At which you get the advantage on. It's going to be against a purple and a red, and you're going to draw an advantage. But I'm going to spend destiny against you, so let's make it a 2 red instead.
All right. This will be fun.
Deception.
Yeah, it could have been worse.
Hey, Lorelei, go ahead and take that and strain.
Okay.
You do that. Well, actually, you don't have to take the strain because you get the free advantage, right?
Yeah.
So there's no strain.
Okay.
So now you are standing in there by yourselves waiting.
IG, go wander to the outside of the door and make sure you can let us know if somebody's coming up the hallway.
Uh-oh. GM flipped a destiny point.
Oh, he used it on Lorelei's.
That was on Lorelei's check.
Mm-hmm. Can Kara, stick her head out the door real quick?
Anon's going to go stand in the hallway and see what's up. He's going to look around. It's his job. So this hallway we're in, is this kind of an empty room, or...?
It's a long, fairly nondescript hallway.
Okay, I just wasn't...
Terminates in a door down here. I keep having to change to select. I'm not used to using... And then you notice that there's a door here. He is not there, by the way.
Okay.
So you've got the door to reception there. You've got the door into the break room there. You've got something here. And then you've got this. But the hallway is essentially clear, except for, now that you know to look for them, more security cameras.
Why don't we just wait in reception? It's reception. That way we're not cornered.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah. Just want to sit down at the...
Yeah, we'll just act... Yeah, there's probably little chairs and coat racks, and we'll just act like we're waiting there for whatever we're picking up, right?
Koska can sit at the desk and put his feet up on it.
Exactly.
Mickey Mouse Bruce.
Yeah, what is this door here? Is there anyone else at the reception desk, or is it just empty?
Not right now.
Awesome. What's this door to?
You don't know. It's closed.
I'm going to try and slice it open.
let's not draw any attention to ourselves at all.
Yeah, let's not act guilty until they think we're guilty.
Just say I'm,
hey, you guys want to
not all there and just have a problem with slicing things? I don't know.
You guys want to kind of move back past the desk so I got a clear shot at both doors?
Yeah, but I want to know what this door is.
I'm sure if people storm out of it, we'll find out.
Hmm. Hey, is there anything in the... Are any of the drawers in the desk open?
Are there security cameras in here?
Yes. At least
let's not rob the place, Kara.
Let's not go snooping. Let's just hang out and wait.
That's very cautious for IG.
Yeah, the first time no one wants to... No one wants to snoop around.
You're in the line of fire. You realize that, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's okay. Just take the
shot. And then you can't use the desk as cover.
Koska, do you want me to give you the edge again?
The edge.
What? I don't know if it
boost your stat by one.
Yeah, I don't know if it'd benefit me past this point in time. If things go sour, it may benefit IG or Andon more.
I can't. You've
got stims? I'll take stims. Let's do some stims.
Pump some oil into them.
You're not doing stims.
Whatever. It's like a popper. It's not real.
I don't want to have to nurse everyone's hangovers when we get back to the ship. I only have so many crackers.
Yeah, whatever.
We'll be like, Kara, it's okay.
I've strained for days. Let's do this.
Bring up my sleeve and there's nothing but needle marks.
Oh, no. I'll literally start crying for real. You know, I don't know if we should just be sitting here. We got to get that guy out. We got to get that prisoner.
Well, supposedly they're bringing us somebody, so.
Do you really think they're bringing us someone?
Do you think someone didn't believe Koskett? Come on, let's step up. Let's do this.
Hey, at this point, they've already called reinforcements in, so.
Is there like a TV or something on the receptionist desk?
No.
With like the security. Oh man, you'd think they'd have that here.
If only you could slice your earpiece into their communications.
I mean, I could try. I mean, I can do contraption to, let's see here. Where is it at?
Well, we know they're using communications because he had an earpiece, so you should just have
to device to solve a current problem.
You should just have to crack the code on your data pad, and you'll be able to listen in. We'll all be able to listen in.
Okay, I'll do that then.
That way, you don't have to build some widget whirligig that.
Well, no, I was gonna try and slice into the security cameras.
Nah.
To see what's happening.
We can see whoever we need to shoot at. Let's get on there. Let's get there.
All right, fine. What am I going to do here? Am I going to do a slice in? I'm going to slice in.
You're going to do a daunting slicing check for
two
multi-dieters. Spooky.
And I'm going to go ahead and spend a destiny on this check as well.
Can I spend a destiny point too?
You sure can, and we'll just leave it alone.
There we go.
But actually, yeah, we'll leave the pool alone, but you're going to upgrade your check and upgrade the difficulty, too.
All right, let me see if I have anything else good here. I don't have that.
If she doesn't get this, she's fired.
Shut up. One second. I got to check one more thing here.
If she doesn't get this, I'm going to have to be starting to stem people.
Hey, I'm volunteering. Let's do this.
Just
and I'm going to use Touch of Fate.
Just jab her in the neck.
That's two boost, right? Touch of Fate?
Yep.
Yep, two boost.
I mean, if you want me to do to end it, I will. Just tell me what you know, just put it to the skills can be the most
effective. Oh my god!
You're fired.
Yeah, let's do this. God. Agility.
Oh my gosh, no!
Don't
you have
about
second chance
moment,
or something?
Let's go ahead and spin that despair. At about that moment, he walks in. He now has five more people with him. They count as minions. And logistically, he's already squatted up with these five minions.
Oh yeah, you got it.
Cool. Is it four strain?
No, it's one. I got the improved.
Perfect.
And he says, we're prepared to take you back to the prisoner, but we have precautions, of course, that we have to follow. We'll need you to turn over your weapons.
Not a chance.
And all of the minions appear to be ready to draw if you're not cooperative with him. He's also pulled his rifle out, and he's holding it.
Oh, God, Anden.
I think you might as well go for the combat, because personally, I feel if we disarm ourselves, we'll be in that prison.
Yeah, me too.
Yep. I got that, Lorelei. Thank you.
Yeah, cool.
Can we really take on all these people?
There's only six of them?
You guys can take on all these people.
I can take on these people, and you guys can get the prisoner.
There we go. Yeah, just leave IG here to get all the people.
I'm just going to look over at IG and say, IG, we've got to give up our weapons.
And what I'm going to think about shooting that? At that point. As soon as he says that, I want to shoot.
Okay.
I want to use All right, let's see.
What is this initiative going to be?
This is vigilant, since we are prepared, correct?
Cool is if we're ready to go.
You're prepared. And I don't know if we've got Knowledge Rhino in the chat right now, but I'm about to try using the super handy-dandy roll for all your minions in one place.
Ooh.
Ability. Really. Let's see if it works. Ha! Look at that.
Nice.
We gotta convince him to use periods instead of colons, because then it's easy to type in others as you get them and then sort.
Yeah.
That's what I was gonna talk to him about. If that's a thing he can do. Because I always do them as like 2.4 and it works really well.
You put those in the dice roller and go to the character sheet on that and scroll to the bottom and put them in manually at that.
You go the character sheet on the dice pool, and then you go to campaign details underneath that. And then it lets you set up an encounter, and at the bottom of it, you can specify the NPCs that you want to use to roll.
I'm going to use Touch of Fate on my initiative roll, if that's okay.
Wow, Goss gets super prepared.
Yeah, you're the one that gave the cue.
That is true.
We got three more initiative rolls still?
Yeah, I'm going to use Touch of Fate on mine
real quick. I think I rolled.
The 1-3, so...
I got a 1-2.
Is there a specific initiative button?
There's one that says, if you go to combat, it says show initiative.
Oh, it's under combat. Okay.
Okay. I'll look for that. Show initiative. There we go.
See if this works. That worked. Oh, good. Damn. Thanks, Touch of Fate.
I feel like I'm the only one that's gotten anything out of boost out tonight.
FK for a second.
Pretty much.
Nice.
All right, these guys are at short or medium range in this room?
They're at short range.
Okay.
Oh, God, they're all dead.
We got all, I'm only counting four PCs right now.
Initiative.
Who did we not get? Anden, Lorelei, Koskett.
Probably Lorelei.
No, mine's. I just re-rolled mine on there, and it came up the 2-0.
You don't have mine. It's a 1-1.
Oh, yeah. We don't have IGs.
Wonder how that happened.
Okay.
Obama. Magic.
Oh, probably because I just rolled under the skill instead of
the initiative. Combat.
Yeah.
Sorry.
All right, I'm back.
We are ready to roll with the first PC slot on our combat turn.
So everyone there is squatted up?
Mm-hmm. You have one guy with a squad of five.
I'll let IGs go first, and then I think if, depending on how it looks, I do have a frag grenade.
All right, I'm going to go for the main guy here, the heavy.
And a room this small with a frag grenade actually hit all of us.
Yeah, are we just all at short range to him?
You are... Well, anybody that's adjacent to anybody else, so Lorelei, Anden, and Kira are all going to be engaged or within short range of each other, as will Koskett, IG, and Lorelei. Any kind of frag that gets discharged is not going to be very pleasant.
All right, then I'll stick to the pistol, probably. I wasn't sure exactly how big the room was.
All right. So, and it increased the difficulty for auto fire?
Oh, and their wound thresholds get reduced by one apiece.
Yep.
Okay. Yep. Let's just go ahead and add one wound.
All right, and here we go.
Okay.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
How is that even possible?
It's 22 damage, potentially twice.
Auto fire! Auto fire!
Yeah, that was auto fire. Oh,
and then you can trigger auto fire with the.
Oh, Lord.
Yes.
Oh my God.
So he splatters.
Well, he's going to defer one of the hits to the first hit, and I guess the second one to the thugs that are with him.
Okay.
So there's now three of them left instead of five.
So they're not a separate minion group?
No, they're in a squad with him, which means that he can force one of the hits on him off onto one of them.
Okay, then not to be pedantic, but shouldn't they not get their own initiative roll then?
No, those initiative rolls are for other okay, cool. NPCs.
No problem. Then.
Yeah.
They're a surprise. Way to go ruining it, Taylor.
Well, I could only see two of them the way my turn order was set up.
No, that confusion is perfectly understandable. So
I just didn't want to make sure it was going to be having it both ways was all. No,
there's only going to be one turn total for this counter right here.
Cool.
Hey, what if Kara uses draw closer and pulls the guy and then Annie can stab him as well?
Are we escalating it?
I think we should escalate
it. We might as well.
Let's escalate it.
All right, Kara, I guess it's your turn then.
Yes! All right, Kara's going to use draw closer. She's going to take out her lightsaber and pull staff or whatever, and she's going to use draw closer, which he's in medium range, right?
He's short.
He's at short range of you right now.
Because it says against the silhouette one target in medium range.
It's within medium.
Okay, yeah.
If it's within medium range, it'll work.
And then add force die. So,
Kara, yeah, it's too purple, right? Turn to combat.
Does he have any adversary or melee defense?
Yeah, he does.
What does he have?
He is. I'm trying to look at. I guess when you're controlling the character sheet, that changes my ability to access it. So give me just a second here.
Yeah, sure thing.
We're looking for his melee. It's going to be four green. He has a melee. It's just brawn four.
No, his melee defense.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, he has no melee defense.
Does he have adversary?
Everybody else is saying you had to go and ask, didn't you? Yes, he does. He has adversary three.
Whew.
So upgrade it three times?
Correct.
Yes.
So it's going to be...
a purple and two red.
Okay. Two red, a purple. All right, I get to do this. I'm going to use destiny point. And I'm going to do a lightsaber check. I succeeded.
Do you have to spend the force pips to get the pull?
Yep.
So you got to spend at least one of those.
Yes, and I will.
That's another conflict for Kira.
Yeah, I know.
And a strain for Kira, and now he's pulled within range.
Hold on. What was that, Taylor?
Gee, Kara, keep this up. You're just going to pull out the force lightning soon.
Well, I just want to pull him. Yeah, I'm going to hit him.
What's your what damage?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm... seven damage. Oh, I got a boost to that one, too. I forgot about that. So it's eight damage?
Eight damage, and it's breach one, I assume.
Yes, here, I can just roll it right now. But I forgot about it. I get a boost on my lightsaber checks, so I can...
Go ahead and roll that.
All right, cool, thanks. Do. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So that negates the threat, yes! And then you actually get an advantage to spend.
Yes, and I'm going to crit.
You can crit for one advantage.
Yes.
She's broken.
I have 4 mods.
Now I'm actually
it's vicious 2.
Okay, crit with vicious 2.
Yes.
Now I'm actually unsure under the squad rules what happens when you crit, but he wants to defer the injury to the wounds to somebody else.
We pulled him out of the squad.
Yeah. Oh, that was part of what you were trying to do, is pull him out of the squad.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's start by giving him what's it going to be? It's going to be 8 wounds.
Yes.
And then we're going to roll for a crit.
Crit plus 20. Yeah. Is that how it works?
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you a 20 offset. And
I assume I that works the other direction.
We're going to do this the opposite way, obviously. I'm going to I'm going to change it so that you get one extra light side point here.
Nice.
And the dark side's down to 3.
Nice. And now Anden can escalate the situation even more.
Anden would love to.
It is Anden's turn.
Okay, Anden just picked up Quick Strike, so he will add a boost. And it'll be a purple and 2 red. He's going to draw his lightsaber as incidental with Quick Draw. He's going to spend 2 strain to aim twice. And he will... Let me see if there's anything else I need to do here, but I don't think so.
Also, I brought him into short range?
You brought him into engaged. I thought he was at short.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay.
And then I get an automatic advantage, which I don't have listed because it's only when I'm engaged with one opponent, so... Yep, that's it. All right, let's see what we get. Make sure I'm not forgetting anything here. There was the starting combat with the on the ship, but that was about it.
Yeah.
And how many destiny points are we at? 5 and 3?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll use one. Alright, let's see what happens here. Oh, hang on, wrong weapon. I gotta rearrange these. Okay. And I get one more advantage, like I said.
You could crit.
I can crit twice, yeah. Let's... Yeah, that'll be 11 damage with Breach. If he's still up after that, I think I'll probably crit.
All right, the 11 damage.
Overachiever.
That does not take him down.
Actually, I have a way better idea. I'm going to use 3 of the... Four damage it'll take. I'm going to use all 4 advantage and destroy his weapon.
Okay.
Is it 3 steps on the weapon broken chain or 4?
It's 3 steps. So with Sunder, you can only get him 2 steps.
Sunder only takes 1 advantage to activate.
Oh, it does?
Yep.
Well, then you've got plenty of advantage for that.
All right, so I'll take those 3, and then I'll pass a boost to whoever's next. No, I'll take a strain back. Never mind, I'll take a strain back.
Cut right through his weapon?
Yeah, I'm just going to slash his rifle in half.
With your lightsaber?
Yep.
And then do you go, hoo-ah! Or make some fancy noise?
I'm probably going to kind of shrug at him like, you shouldn't have picked this fight. Turns out I'm not an ordinary hired gun. I'm one that also...
Yeah, Kara just, grabbed him by the force and pulled him into her lightsaber, and then Anden used his lightsaber to cut
him
weapon.
And his rifle. And I need to look something up. I don't know, I think it takes a maneuver to activate my boots, so I'll do that next turn. I'm done, by the way.
He goes next, doesn't he?
Somebody does. Presumably him.
So now we got to an NPC's turn. And around the corner into the room comes another creature. And this is a Clatoonian, very large, very imposing. He's carrying a heavy blade. And he runs straight across the room to Andon into an engaged position and then takes a swing at him.
All right, I'm going to use dodge to upgrade his check twice.
Okay.
Do you have defensive from the sword or anything?
I do. I have melee defense, one from the armor and one from the lightsaber.
Andon's kind of OP.
So we got two, and then we're upgrading the check twice?
Yes.
He's going to, like, drop his weapon. Break it.
And here we go. So that is 13 damage, and he is going to take some strain in laying it down.
All right, I will use parry to absorb some of that. Let me look and see how much. Oh, I only have one rank of parry. Okay.
What is that, 3 damage?
Yeah. So 3 from parry, 3 from soak. I'll get rid of 6 of the 13, so I'll go down 7. There we go.
And incidentally, I am counting up on these characters. I've about been convinced by you all that that's the better way to do it.
Oh, sure.
So, you know.
Well, my number's in the same place either way. I just got to switch strain.
Sorry for the confusion.
There we go.
But I'm counting up the NPCs now instead of down.
Oh, geez, I count down.
I like counting up.
Like health bars?
No.
And I need to go back. I did not account for the strain on this other guy a second ago, so he's not going to have quite, he's not going to be quite as wounded for his soak, so he's not going to be quite as wounded as
what other guy? The only people we've hit we had reach.
This one, oh that's right, so never mind, that's right. And that's the end of his turn, we're back to a PC turn.
We got Koskett and Lorelei.
Paper, rock, scissors.
By all means, feel free.
Okay. I will draw and shoot at this guy that's right here in front of me. This kind of like ran in the room. Ah! You know, so.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, he is at short range, so that's going to be an easy attack. And he does have he has one defense. So you will be you'll be rolling one setback.
Yep.
He also, I'm sorry. He also has adversary
15.
That's not 15. He also has adversary 3. So you're actually going to end up with by the time you upgrade that roll 3 times, you're going to be red, 2 reds.
Damn. I'm going to shoot the squad then.
you're going to shoot at the 3 mercenaries that are left over here.
Yeah, I have a better chance of hitting them.
Yeah, and then you won't accidentally hit us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Quotation mark.
She's actually not. She's actually pretty. I mean, she's quick draw, boom, you know. But it's just like, okay. Never mind. So it's still 1.
That'll just be 1.
Okay, so we will go with that.
That toilet looks really greasy.
And there's only 3 of them left now, so that's going to be... Yeah. Going to adjust their health there. Okay. Oh, you went ahead and rolled.
Yeah.
Okay.
Give me a boost die.
Okay, I'll give him a boost because I missed, so.
Distracting fire.
Yeah.
I'm going to actually use this gun for the second time. Averaging once a year.
So who's next?
The one and only.
The one and only casket.
I'm going to draw my X30. I'm going to suffer 2 strain and aim. And I'm just going to shoot the minions as well. Okay. What difficulty was that? 1?
It's you're at short range, so yeah, it's 1 difficulty. They don't have any defense.
We got 4 points. Mind if I go ahead and use 1 upgrade?
Sure.
Because this isn't going to be pretty either way. I also have accurate, so I get 1 extra boost die on top of that.
Oh, look at that.
That's going to be pretty.
You could crit!
Yeah, crits will take out extra 1 extra minion. So you do 6.
I can kill 2 people.
It's amazing. Yeah, I'll crit. Drop 1, and then that does 5-6 damage, pierce 2.
Yeah, so that's going to do 6 minus 2 is 4, plus 6 is going to do a total of 10 damage, which takes that. You take out 1 of them, and you do some damage to a second one. So there's 2 of them that are left now.
Koskett finally killed somebody.
He's getting gritty now.
Comms isn't going to help when they're right in front of you.
Oh, yeah, okay, never mind. Forget that. Forget I said anything.
In this next NPC slot, this heavy is going to do a double move, and he's going to move out into the hall. To right here.
Howard.
No.
And then the next slot, nothing that you notice happens, but you're hearing a lot of commotion down in this part of the hall. I don't know if you've got it up on your screen, but you're hearing a lot of commotion coming from down this way.
That's fine. We'll deal with that in a second.
All right. Is it another NPC turn, or I'm sorry?
Yeah, I'm sorry. We're at the top of the next round, and we're back to a PC slot.
Andon, do you want to stab this guy, or do you want me to stab him?
I'll stab him.
All right, I'll stab him next.
Okay, you got a maneuver. You want to do something with it, or
I'm going to. No, I'm just going to aim. Let me see here. Go through my skills real quick, but I don't think there's anything I need to worry about. Yep, I'm just gonna aim and cut this guy.
Okay.
So he is adversary 3, you said? Does he have any melee defense?
He has melee defense, and he's adversary 3.
Okay. And I'm now only engaged with 1 person, so I'll get that automatic advantage again.
Nice. I thought Adversary 3 meant 3 red.
No, because it's only 2 purple, and then it's upgraded 3 times.
Oh, okay.
So, I will do 10 damage, breach 1.
And he will activate an ability called Unmatched Protection. He's going to spend a destiny point, which I will give to you here. And he's going to half that amount of damage before applying soak, so he's going to take 5 damage instead.
And I will spend...
Ooh. Isn't that a signature ability?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Ah, okay, thought it sounded familiar.
Yeah, same thing the bounty hunter had that we greased.
Mm-hmm, and his war droids. He can do that as an incidental?
I think Lucky so, Brad. Yeah. I think anybody
can. How beat up does he look? Because we can't see his health bar, or at least I can't.
Let's see if I can make that visible.
I can see it on my screen.
And I see not red bar, but I thought that was his strain.
Here, let me see if you can. If I just move the character there. Can you see it now?
Nope.
No, it's not showing.
He's looking about a third of the way, if you could see his health bar. I don't know why you can't.
I can see a red bar.
That's it.
Did you miss the damage last turn, then? Or no, I cut the other guy last turn.
It was
turn.
The other guy, it wasn't him.
Hang on.
You didn't miss his damage last turn.
Yeah, I'm going to spend the 2 advantage to sunder his weapon twice.
Okay.
I forget what upgrade that... I think it upgrades the difficulty of the attack or increases it or something like that. I'll have to go look.
Well, if you just put it in the character sheet, it will automatically do it for you.
Oh, excellent. Because I think it also decreases the damage by 1 or something, too.
Oh, it does. It does the sunder. It affects the sunder as well, huh?
Yeah.
As you get to the weapon, you can drop the quality from new to minor and moderate and whatever.
Yeah, it goes new to minor, moderate, and major damage.
Okay, so I'll change it to major damage.
Andon, you should step back.
No, I'm not scared of him.
Oh, because I'm going to, try and hit him.
Melee attacks don't get upgraded.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, so I'm good. I'm going to... I do have 1 more maneuver if I want to spend strain. Shoot, 1 second. I know I've seen this somewhere.
I thought you spent the strain to sunder.
I'm going to take a guarded stance. I'll spend 2 strain to take guarded stance. Gain another +1 melee defense. Perfect.
All right, cool.
I'm all done.
All right. Okay. Can Kara use draw closer again?
Yes, you can.
Awesome. I mean,
you're not drawing him very far at all, but you can do that if you want to.
And I'm going to use a destiny point. And I'm going to roll this bad boy here.
Dealing with an adversary 3.
Yep. And no defense or anything?
He has defense of 1.
Defense 1.
Okay. Are you for real? Okay, wait, hold on. Hold on, I have something for this. I totally do.
A face palm?
No, I have an actual thing. Oh, crap, I can't do that. Never mind. Spend triumph for 3 advantage on the missed lightsaber attack. Well, crud. Okay. Well, no, because then I'll just have the advantage.
Well, yeah, but you'd still have 2 advantage you can spend on something. You can add a setback to his next check.
Looks like you need a couple of talents and second chances.
Yeah, I'll add a setback to his next thing, and maybe he's just not used to big glowy sticks.
That's probably going to throw even the toughest Clatoonian off a little bit.
You know, 6 foot tall, gangly, redhead chick with a big stick with a light on it.
Looking probably has not dark run into that before.
Rounds go on.
What was that costume?
Huh? Looking more and more dark side as the rounds go on.
No, she didn't use any dark side this time. All right.
She's just going to end up using force lightning out of one hand and being like, oh, I didn't know my weapon did that.
Oh, shit.
Lorelai's going to get really, really bad feelings.
All right, so I guess I'm done there.
All right, next PC.
All right, you guys good with him, or you want me to shoot him?
You could if you shoot him, it would upgrade your check and possibly shoot them too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm probably not going to hit him.
IG really needs to go after the heavy.
Yeah, fine, just go ahead.
Shoot the other guys, we got this guy.
Just shoot me, who cares?
Do not just shoot us.
I agree with Kara, just shoot him, who cares?
Oh my goodness.
I'm the one that's engaged with him, not you.
So am I.
Oh.
Okay. I don't think I'd hit you guys, I got a pretty good aim.
It's a despair, it's really out of your hands.
Yeah.
Alright, and there's two guys left in this group here.
Yes. You drop two.
It's possible me and Lorelai could get the two minions. We could get the minions easier than we could get that guy.
Yeah.
If you auto-fire, you can... Well, no, because you have to shoot at the hardest guy first. Still, you could do both.
Yeah, I'll sprag both of them if I hit with auto-fire.
You just have to hit the Klaatuinian first.
Now, where you're at right now, you don't have line of sight to the heavy... But you could move into a position out in the hallway where you'd have line of sight to both of them. And I realize we don't have any strict line of sight rules in this book as it's. But I.
That's yeah, but he's obviously out of the room, so. Yeah, I think I'll shoot I'll take out the other two guys here.
Okay.
You're not going to shoot the guy we're trying to kill?
Well, I can shoot him if you want me to. I've got faith I won't
hurt you. Kara trusts in the Force.
Okay.
Just pull the trigger. Do what you're best at.
All right. I'm shooting at the guy, and I will flip a destiny point just to be sure.
Two despairs.
You're shooting at this guy.
The Klaatuinian. I can't see.
Oh, you are going to the Klaatuinian. Okay.
All right. Let's see. Here we go.
Yeah. See? What were you worried about? The, like, 2-1-in-12 chances of a despair and in going down.
Hey, can you use that triumph to do auto fire and then the 2 advantage for auto fire?
Yes.
Do auto fire twice?
Yeah.
Daka daka daka.
That is a thing you can do.
Yeah. You upgraded the difficulty for auto fire.
Did I? Nope, I didn't.
Roll another purple.
Okay, let me take everything else out of here.
Clear.
That's what we need, a clear button.
There is a clear button on the dice thing.
There is.
Okay, so take 2 of those success out.
That's still 3.
Yep.
Still 18 damage.
Yep. So I'm going to put 18 on the Klaatuinian.
So that's 9 more points then.
And I'll use one of the auto fires on him and then one on one of these little peons over here. Can I do that?
Yep.
There we go.
Actually, I'm just going to use them all on him and make sure he goes down.
It's just a smoldering corpse. those swoop bike people released on us, you mowed down instantly.
He's so just spraying fire and we're catching it on our lightsabers, managing to not get shot.
So you're going to hit him 3 times?
Yes.
Okay.
There we go.
He flies back against the wall here and then just kind of flays and falls down onto the ground.
Everyone make a fear check for IG?
Not us, just them. We should have made the thugs do one.
Ah, crap. Oh, well. Never mind. I was too busy shooting him anyway.
That is true. As an incident, as an incidental, can we tell the minions to step down after seeing that?
You can just yell, "Drop him."
I drop him. Not as an incidental, but you know, if somebody like Koskett wants to try to get them to give up, he can. As an action on his turn. So IG's done?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right. This guy is going to continue to run down the hall, and he's going to go through this door right here and disappear on his turn. And now we're back to a PC slot.
I'll let Koski go this time.
I'll use cutting question to coerce them into dropping their weapons and be like, "Do you want to end up like that guy?" And point to the bullet holes in the wall and the blood.
Four. Maybe a limb. Dead.
That's like three boosts on that check.
15 boosts.
Let's see. Three.
Let's go
boosts.
Against willpower of three. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm looking at your sheet, Koskett. Hang on.
I was going to say, those are some pretty willful thugs.
And Koskett's going to throw his own gun down. All right.
I convinced myself.
Willpower of two.
Okay, do this manually because I'm using cutting question. It goes off of coercion, but it uses my deception.
You got to make that custom skill sometime.
Yeah, so it's like willpower, which my willpower is three, so it's three upgraded five times, three boost die gets two. All right.
Wow.
Okay, they're fighting for us now. Enjoy your new goons.
They're not quite fighting for you, but they do drop their weapons, and you can pick something else for that triumph if you want.
Get them to tell us what they're doing. What the guy's
running. Yeah, where did he run to? Do they have reinforcements down the hall?
So they just let slip, "Don't kill us, the reinforcements will never make it," and put their hands up. So you're pretty sure there's reinforcements coming.
All right, IG, kill him.
Okay.
Dude, no! They just surrendered. We're not doing that. We're not having this fight again right now.
I just do what Koskett says, so...
All right, last PC slot here.
I'll take the double move to go down to here. So
you're actually gonna pursue the heavy.
Yeah, but I'm not getting anywhere in the view. I'm like kind of get my back to the wall, pressed up in case they
James
do
Bond.
That. Let me stick my head out, you know. So.
So you're just back up against the wall, kind of waiting for whatever happens next.
So I got line of sight here and line of sight to the door and things like that. So
okay, I'm going to take these guys out. I just lost my server connection briefly.
Yeah, I got a message up there too for a couple of seconds.
Oh, I didn't see it.
But
I think I have a stim pack, Andon.
I have one. I wanted. She's probably better
with
them.
I think we're going to be okay. I think I just got it once. Let's go ahead and get these two NPC turns done, and then it's actually just going to be one right now, and then we'll start up at the top next time. So coming bursting out of this door here are another five minions, which I'm going to disconnect right now from that character sheet so that I can change their wound level. And they stop very abruptly and see that Lorelei's standing there and open fire on her.
Figured.
Whoops.
Uh-oh. Ah, crap. Please don't die.
Any range defense?
Nope.
Okay. She's in like jeans and a t-shirt.
All right, here we go.
That's Can she at least give them a flirtatious smile before they shoot so they get a disadvantage? Tee hee.
She'd just be like, hey, they're down the hall.
So that's 9 damage, and they'll take a strain, which they'll take as a wound, of course. 9 damage minus soak.
Okay. So... yeah, that hurt. So,
gosh, girl.
As long as you don't die, we'll be there in a minute.
How much health does Lorelai have?
Guys, I'm not the same level as you.
Oh.
You got to remember that.
Yeah, he's about... she's about... what, 150 points below everybody else? I can't remember.
Oh.
I think it was almost, yeah, it was close to that.
Oh, I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
Well, you guys picked me up from a prison thing. I got, like, no armor. I've got no defensive skills. I've got, I can fire a gun. You know?
You'll be all right. Just don't die before we get there.
Yeah, we'll save you. I'll drop some rocks on their heads or something. Maybe.
Right. And nothing will happen in the next NPC slot. For the time being, at least, and we'll move up to the top of the next turn order, and that's where we're going to have to pick up next time.
That's fine.
Aww.
So for tonight, we're not going to have any roles for the force sensitives. First off, second off, we'll award 15 XP. For tonight, I'll put that up on the board here in a few minutes. And then finally, let's go over and have a look at the contribution rank screen.
Of course.
Yeah, yeah, so tonight, we've got 5 points for IG on the combat superiority. Which what does Koskett's deal do on that? Somebody remind me.
I think you get
like more? 2 or 3 more points or something like that.
Positive spin. Yeah, 3 more points.
Okay, so that's 8 combat superiority for IG. We'll award another 3 apiece, which will add up to 6. For Kira and Lorelai for adding support and creating this contraption, which did help you somewhat to catch them off guard.
Hooray! We did something!
So that's a total of 20 points now. Is that updating as I'm changing it?
Yes.
Okay, nice. All right. And that will conclude our intrepid adventures for the evening. I'm going to shut down the stream now, but thanks for whoever's in there for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We will be back in a couple of weeks.
Night.